As you can see, I'm standing out in front of Charter TV 3 in Worcester right here, Massachusetts. Beautiful Worcester, Massachusetts. Hey, one of the things that Charter brings us is cable TV, internet and telephone service. I do a television show on Charter Communications TV 3, which is actually channel 193. I don't know. Make some sense out of that for me, please. My show airs on Saturday mornings at 9 a.m., it also airs Sunday mornings at 1 a.m. if you're up late, can't sleep. And it airs Wednesdays at 10 a.m. The name of the show is America, What's Happening Now with Hermes Yannis, yours truly. Now, why am I standing in front of this Charter sign or alongside of it? What is it that I'm going to share about Charter, my experiences here with Charter? Well, if you are lucky enough to catch my first show of this season, which was about 5 weeks ago, 6 weeks ago, you would notice that on there I have a graphic that says the show is being censored. That's right, censored. You know, something that like the communist government would do to its people, censor them. You know, somewhere where like they chop people's heads off, you know, where they cut people's hands off, you know, maybe in Iraq, Afghanistan, you know, Iran, you know what I'm talking about, censorship. Maybe even in places like Saudi Arabia. You know, where women can't even show their face. If they show their face, they cut their head off. Well, Charter Communications TV 3 right here seems to be following in their footsteps. Now, they determined that one of the things that I was covering, a specific issue I was covering, was the church sexual abuse scandal, they call it. It's not a scandal. It's criminal activity, raping children. Priests raping children. That's criminal. They destroy lives. Numerous lives. Well, on my first show, I had the Bishop McManus of the almighty Worcester Diocese. Also had a mother on that show, in her own words, describing what her son, her family has gone through since her son was raped by a priest. Right here in Worcester. Raped right here in Worcester. By a priest. Now, Mike Massey, who is the programming, I don't know, boss, chief, guru, whatever he is, at Charter TV 3 here, decided that he thought it was not in good taste. Charter Communication, at that time, I thought that they must have some kind of a policy statement. They must have some type of rules and regulations that they didn't give me when they took my check. Because I pay for my airtime in advance, well in advance. So, after they take my check, after the show aired twice, on the third day it was supposed to air, all of a sudden it's an issue, there's a problem. All of a sudden we have rules and regulations. I make Mr. Massey aware of the First Amendment of the Constitution of our United States, which says in part that Congress cannot make any law prohibiting the freedom of speech, freedom of the press, which I am, by the way, as well. I'm press, a member of the press. And they cannot infringe on anybody's right to freedom of speech, freedom of expression, or freedom of press, like Mr. Massey did. That's what he did. See, so I suspect that Mr. Massey is of the frame of mind that if it doesn't pass muster with him, his sole arbitrary judgment, then it can't be aired on Charter Communications TV. Well, I'm here to tell you that I'm doing this on the internet because you don't think that Mike Massey would allow this to air on Channel 3, do you? We still live in America. We still have a constitution. We still have a right to freedom of speech. We still have a right to freedom of expression. We still have a right to freedom of press. It doesn't say anything about the right to be depressed or oppressed. So I'm here to tell you that as an American, I'm bringing you American issues, things that matter in this country, things that will not be politically correct, things that will make you want to think at least about why we've gotten to the point we've gotten to where we're afraid to speak our minds about anything. People like Mike Massey, people like Barack Insane Obama, people like Hillary, the murderer Clinton, those people that want to restrict your freedoms, want to take away your freedoms, we can't let them. And we're not gonna let them. Hillary Clinton fashions herself as a woman that wants to pave the way for women's rights. She has a television commercial that I've seen a few times that I want to gag and spit and puke over, where there's a young girl that says, oh, Ms. Clinton, if you make it to the president, will they have to pay you the same as they pay a man? And everybody laughs, and Hillary laughs, and they all just have a great fucking time. Well, Hillary Clinton, for those of you that don't know it, has accepted millions of dollars in contributions from the Saudi Arabian government, from people in Iraq, Iran, Afghanistan, and Pakistan. All countries that treat their women like shit. All countries that behead their women if they even want to speak out. Countries where the Taliban, ISIS, and all those other neat little fun-loving, head-chopping off people come from, that treat their women like shit. These are the people that are behind Hillary Clinton. These are the people she's accepting campaign contributions from. I think that if she really, really cared about women's rights, especially in America, she wouldn't be taking money from the people that beat, maim, stab, rape, murder, and burn to death women. She wouldn't take their money. So anyone, knowing these facts, these are facts that have been reported in the press, widely reported in the press, and never denied by Hillary Clinton, anybody voting for her, knowing that this happens, you have to be a moron to vote for her. And if you're a woman and you vote for her, you are a total disgrace to the human race, let alone to the females of this world. You all should be sent to Iran, Afghanistan, Pakistan, and given over to them so they can do to you what they do with their women. And that's on the way here to America. And Hillary Clinton will help them bring that here to a neighborhood near you real soon. So join with me and start watching the show more on my YouTube channel than I say Chatter TV 3, because when it comes to using the freedom of speech that we do have, and we're losing our freedoms left and right at a rapid pace, you want to stay tuned and you want to hear the truth the way I tell it, and you want to see it on my YouTube channel. You'll see it at a minimum at Chatter TV 3, but I'm still doing my show my way. I'm not running and hiding from Mike Massey, Chatter, or anyone else, because I have the United States Constitution on my side. And if they get cocky enough, if they get pushy enough, then we're just going to have to go to U.S. District Court and see what the judges have to say about that. So enjoy the show from here on out. You're watching America, What's Happening Now with Hermes Yanis. And don't forget, Chatter Boo! America, yay!
Visit the Seven Hawks Media booth at the 2016 Springfield Motorcycle Show, January 16th and 17th. For more information, visit osegmotorcycle.com. Watch for our new Biker New England TV show, featuring biker news, custom builders, painters, tattoo artists, biking, bands, and much more. To advertise, 774-289-5989. Limited advertising slots available.
people won't ever know. You said I gotta go, and don't leave me. I'll be home soon, please wait for me. The dreaded day came, you were off on your way. With tears in our eyes, we said our goodbyes. I said, come home to me, as soon as can be. Then you got on that bus, and I fell to my knees. I know my life won't be the same.
Reach out and touch you. I said, Grandpa, what's this picture here? It's all black and white, and it ain't real clear. Is that you there? He said, yeah, I was 11. And times were tough back in 35. That's me and Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm and a Great Depression. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Oh, and this one here was taken overseas in the middle of hell in 1943. Almost see my breath. That was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day we left. couple of kids just trying to save each other. You should have seen it in color. A picture's worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color. This one is my favorite one. This is me and Grandma in the summer sun, all dressed up the day we said our vows. You can't tell here, but it was hot that June. That rose was red and her eyes were blue. And just look at that smile, I was so proud. That's the story of my life. Right there in black and white.
Remember? So long. Thank you so much. Thank you.